I start. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise for the processional? Good evening. Tonight, the Penn State Great Valley School of Graduate Professional Studies conducts commencement exercises. All are in their places. These exercises for the summer 2021, fall 2021, and spring 2022 are hereby called to order. For this commencement, we have also invited graduates from the summer 2019, fall 2019, and spring 2020 semesters to participate, as they didn't have the opportunity to attend a live commencement ceremony at our campus.
Thank you, Dr. Botter.
Good evening. I'm Jim Nemes, Chancellor and Chief Academic Officer of the Penn State Great Valley Campus. And I want to welcome you to our spring 2022 commencement. Please stand and remain standing and join us in the singing of our national anthem led by Penn State alum Alan Pye. Academic caps should remain on during the singing of our national anthem. The words to the national anthem are on the inside front cover of your program.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the university, I am pleased to welcome you to these commencement exercises at the Penn State Great Valley School of Graduate Professional Studies. Before we begin, I'd like to ask everyone to please silence their mobile devices. And also to let you know our ceremony will be recorded and will be available later on our website. The modern commencement ceremony is a tradition still followed throughout the world. The symbols and the academic regalia that the faculty, administration, and graduating students wear go back to medieval times. The mace before me is the historical symbol of the authority of the university. Yet the spirit of the commencement ceremony is contemporary. It celebrates this extraordinary milestone of personal achievement. Founded in 1963 to serve adult professionals, this special mission graduate campus of Penn State University is in its 59th year in the Philadelphia region. We moved to this location in 1988, and this commencement marks the 32nd formal commencement ceremony at this campus. At this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our platform party. Please stand and remain standing as I call your name. Mr. Steve Perrone, Vice President, Client Success, OR Intelligence, and Chair of our Advisory Board. Mr. Nikunj Shah, Manager, Paravita Solutions, and our Alumni Representative. Dr. Joachim Botter, Associate Professor of Data Analytics and Chair of the Great Valley Faculty Senate. And Colonel Jeffrey P. Lipson, U.S. Marine Corps, retired, and CEO, Layer 8 Security. Please be seated. I'd also like to introduce some special guests that we have with us this evening. Ms. Pam Lochner, President, Lochner & Associates, and a member of the Campus Advisory Board. And Ms. Susie Lipson, wife of tonight's commencement speaker, Jeffrey Lipson, and his daughter, Ms. Sienna Lipson. At the end of tonight's ceremonies, our school will have graduated 503 students from our master's degree programs this academic year. Of those, more than half were enrolled in the 7 programs that we offer online. They live across the United States and beyond, and several of the online students and their families and friends have made plans to be with us tonight, traveling from California, Louisiana, Maryland, New Jersey, New York, and Rhode Island, and of course, throughout Pennsylvania. I would like to thank all of the Great Valley faculty and staff, and particularly the members of the Commencement Committee who have worked so hard to help make this event happen. It is now my great privilege and honor to introduce our commencement speaker, Colonel Jeffrey P. Lipson, U.S. Marine Corps, retired, and CEO, Layer 8 Security. Jeffrey J.P.L. Lipson is a retired Marine Colonel with over 30 years of military service. An avid technologist and experienced entrepreneur, Jeff is a recognized subject matter expert in the fields of information assurance and cybersecurity, and has a master's degree in information science from the Pennsylvania State University. Jeff's last active duty tour was the National Security Agency with Marine Forces Cyber Command before forming Layer 8 Security. A career intelligence and communications officer, he deployed overseas numerous times, including deployments to Iraq, Liberia, and Bosnia. Please join me in welcoming Colonel Jeffrey P. Lipson.
Thank you, Chancellor. Thank you, faculty. Thank you, staff. Thank you, parents. Thank you, graduates. I have a couple of colleagues in the audience. Thank you. Thank you to my wife and daughter. I have to say that that guy that was introduced sounds pretty amazing. Where is he? You actually have my speech in your booklet, but as I told Sue and the Chancellor, I may or may not stick to script, so bear with me. Normally, I like to walk around, so this podium is a little odd for me. I like to talk with my hands, but we'll do the best we can. I do have to warn you, I love movie quotes. So you're going to have lots of references of movie quotes, and hopefully most of you know them. I like to use them as a point of reference. So if you don't, hopefully you can Google them quickly while you're sitting in the audience. But keep paying attention, or I'll throw something at you. Well, as I thought about what I wanted to say, and I thought about how long it's been since I've graduated, it's 25 years. Sometimes that in itself can be overwhelming. I remember when I thought being 25 was old, let alone having graduated 25 years ago. But as my teammates will tell you, I talk about my time here at Penn State all the time. In fact, we had an all-hands meeting today, and I brought it up. Dr. Sosik is not here today. He was one of my favorite professors. He taught me Management 501. And he and I had many healthy debates, leadership versus management. And since he's not here, I can tell you handedly, I won every single one of those debates. But one of the things he said, day one, was, what does your factory make? And we were all confused, like, what are you talking about? And he said, it doesn't matter if your factory makes widgets, or cars, or performs services. At the end of the day, if your factory doesn't make money, you're out of business. Now that may be simple to say, but that is the root of all business. And I would tell you, before we can have activism in business, before we can have responsible corporate activities, at the end of the day, we still have to have profits. Capitalism is good. Now, I'm not going to go so far as Gordon Gekko from the movie Wall Street, if anyone knows that reference, and say greed is good, but capitalism allows us to do a lot of things. One of the things that I also learned from Dr. Sosik was servant leadership. Now, in the Marine Corps, they taught us leaders eat last. And I put that into practice. As my teammates will tell you, we had a team meeting today, we served lunch, and guess who ate last? That's because you want to make sure that all your teammates eat before you. Now, what does that got to do with business? Well, my company pays bonuses. We've done really well. I paid out some good bonuses to my teammates. Guess who didn't take a bonus? Me. Why did I do that? Because leaders eat last. It was more important for me to make sure my teammates, my stakeholders, were able to enjoy the benefits of their hard work. So remember that. Leaders eat last. Servant leadership. We'll come back to it. When I was here at Great Valley, I had an opportunity to go up to Penn State, Maine, and I got to see Elie Wiesel speak. Does anyone know who he is? Sounds familiar? I get a couple nods. So Elie Wiesel was a Holocaust survivor and a Nobel Prize winner. And he said something that was so profound that I've kept it with me my whole life. So I'm going to paraphrase, because I don't want to mess up his quote. But he, in effect, said, the only thing that we really have, the only thing that we really can say is ours, is our education and our knowledge. He said, when the Nazis came, they took away my home, they took away my stuff, they took away my freedom. But what they couldn't take away was what I had in my head. And Elie was able to use that knowledge to keep himself alive in the concentration camps. So what I want to encourage all of you to do is be lifelong learners. You've got your graduate degrees right now, but that's not the end of your journey. I'm going to make a shameless plug for Penn State Great Valley. Your graduate degree is not the only thing that you can get here. I actually took a whole bunch of courses besides my graduate degree. I got my project management certificate. I got my CISSP prep course from here on my way to getting that certificate. I even took a shop class in Photoshop, which is pretty cool, powerful tool. So there are lots of things that you can do here. So don't let this be the end of that journey. The thing I would tell you is, you just don't have to do academic things to be lifelong learners. My wife is learning Italian. She got a tutor. Mazel tov. My daughter and I volunteered to be firemen from the Lionville Volunteer Fire Department. In the past couple of weeks, I've learned how to prime a hydrant. I've learned how to drive the giant truck. And last night, I learned how to cut holes in the roof so you can vent the fire. Be lifelong learners, no matter what the endeavor is. Never be satisfied. My wife and I like to have this philosophical debate between evolutionary and revolutionary. So what do I mean by that? Evolutionary is the gradual steps to improve something. So most of you may have an iPhone, maybe an iPhone 10, 11, 12, right? There's not a lot of difference between the features. They are evolutionary steps. But revolutionary is the fact that you even have one. So, what does it take to be a revolutionary? What does it mean to be a disruptor? Do you have to be like an evil tyrant, a mad scientist, Dr. Evil? $1 million. Can I get a frickin' laser beam? Being a disruptor, being a revolutionary is a state of mind. It's who you are and how you are. You guys are recent graduates. You are the leaders that are going to be going into the workforce. You've already been in workforce, but now you're going to take your graduate degree and you are going to be the leaders. You are going to be the disruptors. Don't sit idle. Don't say, oh, the status quo. I urge you, I challenge you. Be disruptors. Be entrepreneurs. You don't necessarily have to start your own business to be an entrepreneur, but you can still think like an entrepreneur. And a lot of people ask me, you know, what's it like to be an entrepreneur? You started your own business. One thing I say to potential entrepreneurs, it's a lot harder than you think it is. But I like to reference Monty Python and the Holy Grail. Hopefully some of you are familiar with that. There's a scene where there's a noble who's talking about building a castle in the swamp. And forgive my accent, I'm going to do my best sort of Scottish accent here. They said it was daft to build a castle in the swamp, but I built it anyway, but it sank into the swamp. So I built a second, and it sank into the swamp. So I built a third. It burned down, fell over, and sank into the swamp. So I built a fourth, and the fourth one stood. And that's what it is to be an entrepreneur. It's a hard path. But the risks are worth the reward. Yeah, they're financial rewards, certainly. Some entrepreneurs we know are billionaires today. I guess they're the evil geniuses. But there's also a secondary benefit, and that's knowing you've disrupted and you've made the world better. Stock market took a hit last couple days, yeah? We are recovering from a pandemic. There's a war in the Ukraine. You know, we face these really uncertain times, and it's difficult. I think people are feeling it. But as you become leaders in your organizations and you think about the things you can do, you can make a difference. If I had a soundtrack right now, I'd be playing Hall of Fame by The Script. Does anyone know that song? We Can Be Champions. So pretend that's playing. Now, since I don't have the music in the background, but pretend, visualize. I will instead quote another one of my favorite movies from The Hobbit, Gandalf. And Gandalf says, "Saruman believes it is only with great power that can hold evil in check. But that is not what I have found. I have found the small things, everyday deeds of ordinary folk that keeps the darkness at bay." And that's something every one of us can do. We can be disruptors. We can be influencers. You, my friends, you are those people, those ordinary folk that can make that difference. Be servant leaders. Be lifelong leaders. Be lifelong learners. Be disruptors. For yourselves, for your community, for your family, for your friends. I know you can be and will be. God bless.
Thank you very much, Jeff. And I would like to present you with a token of our appreciation, the Penn State Lion. I would now like to ask Steve Perrone to come forward to the podium.
Thank you, Dr. Nemes. As many of you know, the legal corporate body of the Pennsylvania State University is its Board of Trustees. This is the body that, by their charter, is given the final responsibility for the governance, welfare, and all other interests pertaining to the university. Although many responsibilities are delegated, ultimate authority rests with the board. By virtue of the authority vested in and as approved by the Board of Trustees of the Pennsylvania State University, I authorize you, as a designee of the president, to confer on each of these candidates the degrees earned as certified by the appropriate college, faculty, and dean. The medallion serves as a symbol of that authority.
Thank you, Steve. I would now like to ask Dr. Colin Neal, Director of Engineering Programs, to preside over the conferring of the master's degrees in engineering.
Thank you, Dr. Nemes. Will the candidates from the Master of Professional Studies in Data Analytics, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering, the Master of Engineering Management, the Master of Science in Information Science, the Master of Science in Data Analytics, and the Master of Software Engineering students, please rise and remain standing. Dr. Nemes, I am pleased to present these candidates for the master's degrees from the Engineering Division.
Thank you, Dr. Neal. I would now like to ask Dr. Karen Duhalla, Director of Management Programs, to preside over the conferring of the master's degrees in management.
Thank you, Dr. Nemes. Will the candidates from the Master of Business Administration, the Master of Finance, Master of Professional Accounting, and the Master of Leadership Development please rise and remain standing? I am pleased to present these candidates for the master's degrees from the Management Division.
Thank you, Dr. Dahala. By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I confer upon you the master's degrees which you have earned with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. You may be seated. The University Marshals will now escort the master's recipients to the stage. The Penn State Great Valley Nomenclator, Professor Sally Sue Richmond, a faculty member in information science, will introduce individual graduate students. Mr. Perrone, Colonel Lipson, Dr. Botter, and Mr. Shaw will join me in congratulating our graduates. Will the first row please stand? And graduates, please be careful walking up the stairs and use the railing. We are proud that 503 students have received master's degrees this year and that many of them are with us tonight. Please hold your applause until all graduates have crossed the stage.
Master of Engineering, Systems Engineering, David Phillips. Master of Engineering Management, Jacqueline M. Martinez. Adam Matthew Moritz. Master of Professional Studies, Data Analytics, Kanara Amin. Alicia Marie Drew Berry. Getanet Alamayehu Gawa. Rama Sarika Ketreti. Shahed Imabud. Sarah Norsini. Amanda Prokop. Harry Karan Reddy Ramallah. Robert Joseph Tapia. Lakshmi Ramachandra Varier. Master of Science, Data Analytics, Miguel Francesco Garcia. Sheng Li Cao.
Yes.
Master of Science, Information Science, Norman Tatenda Masuela. Indri Sari. Master of Software Engineering, Boina Kubiri. Joseph Amadeo Gordon. Noah Udafia. Alexandria Marion Wenzel. John Wooten. Master of Business Administration, Alexis Ibuchim Imani Akarolo. Brianne Lynn Albin. Paul Christopher Bowman. Anthony Concha. Stephen Crump. Jessica Kowalski. Jennifer Nguyen. Harry Noka. Aaron W. Perry. An Pham. Brandon Prince. Lauren Roble. Matthew Shirley. Laura Elaine Sullivan. Tyler Tillman. Lou Wong. And Diola Waziri. Alicia Zerbe. Master of Finance and MBA, Wingsy Yip. Master of Leadership Development, Caitlin Everett Baker. Casey Coxon. Adam Charles Morrison. Master of Professional Accounting, Caitlin Megan Lunsford. Kimberly Nguyen.
Sit.
Will the master's recipients please stand and face the audience? Please join me in applauding their achievements. Graduates, you may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the conferring of the degrees, but not the program. Tonight, we also recognize and celebrate students who are the recipients of the 2021-2022 Outstanding Student Achievement Awards. Award winners are nominated and selected by the faculty in each academic program. The awards recognize overall outstanding graduate student achievement in areas that include academic performance, research, student leadership, community service, and citizenship. Tonight, we have award winners from three of our academic programs attending this commencement. I will ask each award winner to stand when I call their names. For outstanding achievement in data analytics, the award goes to Miguel Garcia. For outstanding achievement in leadership development, the award goes to Adam Morrison. For outstanding achievement in professional accounting, the award goes to Caitlin Lunsford. Each student will receive an engraved Nittany Lion statue. Congratulations to all. In addition, we'd like to announce these awards which were given previously. The Quality Enhancement Award recognizes a select number of students enrolled in a graduate degree program at Penn State Great Valley who demonstrate academic excellence. It is an honor bestowed after a faculty review of students based on their academic performance, contributions, and class participation. Funds are generously donated by the Penn State Graduate School Office of Graduate Fellowships and Awards. One of the 21-22 award winners is graduating tonight, Lauren Robel. Congratulations, Lauren. The Henrietta Potter Hankin Award honors and recognizes a graduate student pursuing a degree in engineering at Penn State Great Valley and has achieved superior academic standing. The award recipient is selected by the engineering faculty, and only one student per year is given this award. The award winner this academic year was Noah Yudofia. Congratulations, Noah. I would also like to take a few moments to highlight other areas of student achievement. Earlier tonight, the Management Division faculty inducted a number of management graduating students into Beta Gamma Sigma. Beta Gamma Sigma is the International Honor Society serving business programs accredited by AACSB International. The Association to Advance Collegiate Schools of Business. Membership in Beta Gamma Sigma is the highest recognition a business student anywhere in the world can receive in a business program accredited by AACSB International. Would those students who were inducted earlier tonight please stand? Penn State also recognizes students for their military service with honor cords. Our graduate students who have honorably served, are serving, or commissioned to serve in the U.S. military have been awarded a red, white, and blue honor cord to wear at tonight's commencement ceremony in recognition of their duty and sacrifice and the pride with which we view their service. We greatly appreciate your service and want to thank you for your unique contributions to campus life in the classroom and beyond. Would all graduating students who are service members on active duty or in the National Guard or Reserves who are veterans, please stand. You may be seated. Tonight, we also recognize the achievements of our faculty. I'm extremely proud of their efforts and what they have been able to accomplish. Faculty awards will be presented at convocation in August, but it is appropriate that we acknowledge them at this occasion. Please stand as your name is called. The award for full-time teaching goes to Patrick Chang, Associate Professor of Operation Management, and Juan Shi, Assistant Professor of Accounting. The award for research goes to Professor Bo Ouyang, Associate Professor of Accounting. The award for faculty service goes to Denise Petoskey, Professor of Management and Organization. The Arthur Glenn Innovation Award goes to Professor Robin Q, Professor of Information Science. And the Diversity Action Council Faculty Award goes to Denise Petoskey, Professor of Management and Organization. I would also like to now announce that the following faculty have received promotion. Dr. Ashkan Negabon, promoted to professor, rank of Associate Professor, Engineering Management. Dr. Joachim Botter, promoted to the rank of Professor, Data Analytics. And Dr. Raghu Sangwan, promoted to the rank of Professor, Software Engineering. I would like to now acknowledge the contributions of family, friends, and employers to the success of our graduates. Without your support, their task would be even more difficult. Many of our students balance full-time employment, part-time graduate education, and lives filled with many other responsibilities. Without your patience and understanding, they might not be here this evening. Finally, I wish to recognize our faculty members who have been teachers, advisors, and mentors in our students' learning. They are equal partners in tonight's celebration. Thank you all for your commitments to higher learning and to the success of all of our students. I'll ask our graduates to stand and face the audience one more time. This time, I would like the graduates to recognize the contributions and support of their families, including family members that cannot be here, friends, and faculty, with a round of applause. Our graduates are the truest measure of our success. Their achievements are the means by which our vision for the future of the Penn State Great Valley Graduate Campus is carried forth into the community, the region, and the nation. Graduates, you may be seated. It is my honor to introduce your student speaker this evening, Ms. Caitlin Baker. Caitlin earned her undergraduate degree in education and mathematics from LaSalle University and is a graduate of the Master of Leadership Development program. She served as a volunteer for the Peace Corps from 2016 to 2018 in Liberia as a teacher, trainer, and as a developer of curriculum. She is a middle school mathematics teacher, and additionally, she runs the Gender Sexuality Alliance for the middle school division at Abington Friends School. Caitlin also received the Madeline and Michael Haynes Scholarship for the spring 2022 semester. Caitlin, please come to the stage.
Must have been on mute. Thank you to everyone who spoke before me for not using the same joke. While I did pass, sorry, I cannot generate APA citations that quickly. I thought it would be nice to start with a Zoom joke, considering many of us took Zoom classes as part of our degree, while also being very, very thankful that we get to have an in-person commencement this year. Thank you, Penn State Great Valley, for all the measures you took during the pandemic to ensure our safety and for making this evening possible. Thank you to the distinguished faculty members for keeping expectations and spirits high during all modes of learning each semester. Thank you to the Penn State Great Valley administrators for organizing our programs and providing us with opportunities that extended well beyond the classroom. To the support systems seated on either side of the graduates, thank you for your patience, encouragement, and willingness to proofread what probably felt like 100 papers, because it was. and to the graduates, congratulations, class of 2020, 2021, and 2022. I'm very honored to be the student commencement speaker this evening. I've been a middle school math teacher for 6 years now, and I'd like to share with you some ideas to help you in your transition beyond Penn State that some of my students have helped teach me. I have shared the highs and lows of graduate school as a way of building connections with my students, sometimes as validation that the things we learned were really hard and interesting, and to change it up a little bit, not talk about math all the time. Earlier this year, call it karma, call it coincidence, but about half of my students got a C on a quiz, and I too got a C on a paper. While this wasn't, you know, a proud moment of mine, I used it as a chance to be a genuine and vulnerable leader for my students. I felt as though they saw me as someone who always got hundreds and school was really easy for me, and that certainly wasn't accurate. Despite all of the devastation that we felt from getting a C, I use this as an opportunity to model a growth mindset. Now, I also shared with them that I was going to be the speaker this evening, and they responded with, either you write the speech about us, or we get to write the speech for you. And curious, I asked the young mathematicians what exactly they were going to write for a speech for me, and they said two things. Can it be a TikTok dance instead? Is there any candy involved for helping you? Mind you, they're 12-year-olds, okay? While the offer was very tempting, my leadership development degree sounded like an alarm in my head. Transactional leadership is not the approach here. So I opted for option one, to write the speech about them. While I might be one of the only teachers graduating this evening, I hope my ideas that I share with you, you're able to connect with and find value. Number one, you are defined by your growth, not by singular mistakes. While we certainly aren't making the same mistakes, hopefully, as 12-year-olds, I think the principle still applies here. I spend hours every year teaching communication skills and social-emotional learning that is centered around being reflective of actions, words, and intentions. We talk about how it's strong, it shows more strength to apologize than it is to get defensive. Leaders have to be able to know when they cause harm, own it, and be able to move on in active reflection of trying not to repeat the same mistake. Everyone else's job is to hold them to it and to give them the time and the space they need to grow. Number two, you do not need to understand someone in order to respect them. Respect looks and sounds like coexistence with the recognition of individual needs. This requires no change of personally held beliefs, except for that other people are allowed to be different from you. As humans, we have a tendency to want to surround ourselves with people who look, act, and believe in the same ways we do. But we all know those groups have a limited track record of success. So, be intentional with inclusivity. Update hiring practices to reduce the amount of implicit bias in decision making, and be open to feedback. While I use the word coexistence to further define respect, I would argue that's a minimum. We have all worked in a job where we were merely existing rather than thriving. Creating a space where everyone can be their best selves requires varying degrees of support and education. Embrace diversity and be willing to put in the work. Number three, the last lesson I learned was one when I was teaching for Peace Corps Liberia, and it was about gratitude. Have you ever started your day, most of us probably do, with asking a colleague how they're doing, and they respond with a litany of things that have gone wrong for them? I find that this kind of workplace energy is often creating connection through burdens and complaints, and it can put our mind into this vicious cycle of negativity. I had a very different experience in Liberia, where even in greeting one another, there is a recognition of gratitude. The appropriate response to good morning or how are you is, I thank God for life. It is a response that recognizes the good, no matter how heavy the bad is. Don't be afraid to tell other people what they mean to you. When I'm having a stressful week, I like to counter that energy with sending a positive email home about a student, highlighting their success and thanking the parent for their partnership in their education. It is a much more productive and effective use of my time and energy than by sharing and that stress and carrying it on to another person. We are in the midst of a labor shift that is demanding immediate changes from leaders, and our work here at Penn State has allowed us to be caring, compassionate, and transformative leaders and stakeholders during this time. As leaders, I encourage you to model a growth mindset even when your mistakes feel devastating. Mandate and model respect for all people, and make time for gratitude. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Caitlin. At this time, I would like to call forward Mr. Nikun Shah, who will give an alumni welcome.
Thank you, Dr. Nemes. Congratulations, graduates. My name is Nikun Shah. I'm the president of the Great Valley Alumni Society here, and I'm really excited to be here. This is the first and only commencement as president that I've been able to attend in person due to the pandemic, and it's really amazing to see all your faces and to welcome you all to the Alumni Association in person. The Penn State Alumni Association celebrates your successes and welcomes you to a proud network of Penn Staters. Your Alumni Association is powered by over 174,000 alumni and friends like you that keep their connections to a world-class university through their membership. And today, on behalf of the Alumni Association, I'm honored to present you with a graduation gift, your first year membership to the Alumni Association for free. Yes, it's very exciting. Your membership keeps you in touch with Penn State and is your gateway to more than over 300 geographically dispersed alumni chapters, interest groups, and college and campus societies. No matter where your career takes you, whether you stay locally here in Philadelphia or relocate across the globe, Penn State alumni are everywhere and will welcome you with open arms. My personal favorite, and I can tell you this story later, is I ran into a Penn State alum from Westchester nonetheless, in a town in New Zealand after I came off of a cruise. So we really are everywhere. After graduation, once you're settled in, reach out to your local Penn State alumni chapter. We have them here at all the local counties, Chester, Montgomery, Delaware, Philadelphia, Berks, and Bucks. And please definitely stay in touch with our campus society. We do a lot of great things and we would love to have you on board with us. In the coming years, whenever you visit Penn State Great Valley or return for more professional development, we hope you'll enjoy your time on campus and stop by the Dallas and D. Kraft Alumni House here on campus or visit the Hintz Family Alumni Center up at University Park. And with that, we'd like to ask our new graduates to please rise. And would all other Penn State alumni here today please rise as well? It gives me great pleasure to induct all graduating students of the Pennsylvania State University into the Penn State Alumni Association. Congratulations again. Please be seated.
All rise. It's your exercise. Ladies and gentlemen, we thus end our commencement ceremonies, and we will now be led in the singing of the Alma Mater by Alan Pye. The words to the Alma Mater can be found inside the front of your program. At the conclusion of the singing of the Alma Mater, please be seated and remain seated while the platform party, faculty, and degree recipients recess as directed by the university marshals. I would like to invite you to join us for a reception with light refreshments in the Conference Center building lobby, where graduates, their families, and friends can mingle with faculty.
For the glory of Old State, for her founder strong and great, for the future that we wait, raise the song, raise the song. Sing her love and loyalty, sing our hopes that bright and free. Rest, O Mother dear, with thee, all with thee, all with thee. When we stood at childhood's gate, shapeless in the hands of fate, thou didst mold us, dear old state, dear old state, dear old state. May no act of ours bring shame to one heart that loves thy name. May our lives but swell thy fame, dear old state, dear old state.
Thank you all once again for joining these 2022 commencement exercises. Thank you.